Hey y'all, this is Carly, and I am here today with the third sort of episode of my wax diaries or my warm reviews. So I've got another roughly around a week of melts. Y'all know that I just keep an empty box and fill it up as I melt, and whenever it gets full, I just go ahead and film a video. So I'm not sure exactly how many days this is, but I would say this is probably how much I melt in about a week. So I will just go ahead and dive in and get started. There are several things that wouldn't fit on the top of my box because I melted several bags this week. So the first thing that I have is Jaws, and this is sea salt, fresh air, seagrass, sliced plum, and sweet pear. This is from Super Tarts, and this was really, really nice. A really nice fresh scent. I really enjoyed it. It wasn't as like overwhelmingly strong as I've heard people say it is, or as I thought that it would be, but that's probably because I haven't had it for very long. And I know that a lot of people say that you don't have to cure Super Tarts at all, but I typically cure all of my wax some. I was just really excited to melt this, and since I had so much of it, I figured that I could just go ahead and melt one piece and try it out. It did throw for a long time, and when I changed it out, it was just because I was ready for a new scent. After probably 4 to 6 hours, I was just ready for something new, but it did perform well. It just wasn't like blow you out of the water strong like I thought it would be, but I'm sure it will be after it cures for a little bit. The next one that I have is a mini melter bag from Rose Girls. This is Treat Yourself, which is her Gilligan's Brew. I think that's like coconut and some other stuff, and then I think this also has pineapple, just kind of a tropical fruity blend. I'm actually melting this right now, and I just put in 2 little mini melter pieces. It's hard to describe how much because they're all kind of different shapes, but it's actually doing pretty well. I can smell it really well. Again, it's not super duper strong, but this hasn't cured for very long at all, and I know for sure that Rose Girls needs to cure. I just, again, was excited to melt it, and I had a bag of it, so I thought I would just try a little bit. And the last one that I have that wouldn't fit in my box is Middle Earth from Super Tarts. This is Dirt, Rosemary, and Fresh Mint Leaf. This one was amazing. I was so excited to melt this. I melted it at night, and it was so, so good. It was such a beautiful, fresh, earthy mint scent, and this performed extremely well. I got this at the same time as Jaws, and I would say this was even stronger than Jaws. This was just so good. Like, I did not want this to end. I put this on at night. I melted it all night. I could still smell it some the next morning. This is amazing. If you like mint at all, I would definitely recommend trying that one when it's available. So now I will dive into this box. I have a sample from Super Tarts and Rocket. And this one, I know it's a Biolage blend. I think it's like Biolage and tangerine or clementine, something along those lines, some type of citrus like that. And this was really good. I've only melted one other Biolage blend before, I think, which is Kong, the pink sugar Biolage. And that one is a little bit too soapy to me, a little bit too strong on the Biolage. This one is perfect. So you definitely smell the Biolage, but it's not too much at all. And it's equally blended with that citrusy note. So it's just a beautiful, fresh, clean scent. So I was really, really impressed with this one, and I definitely want to try to get this in a clamshell. I'm sorry if y'all can hear them mowing outside. They mow on Fridays at my apartment, and this is just when I had available to film. If it gets too loud, I'll pause or something. So this is from Blank Label. This is 10 Things I Hate About Puppy Love, and this is strawberry cheesecake, vanilla ice cream, vanilla wafers, and creamy zucchini cake pops. This one was so good. I've only melted one other thing from Blank Label before, and it was a nighttime blend, but this one was beautiful. You could really get the strawberry cheesecake with a little bit of a bakery note, and it was really strong, and it lasted for a long time. This was a really, really nice scent. This was another one that it was kind of hard for me to change out when it was done because it was so good. Really enjoyed that one. This is from Front Porch that I got in a D-stash. This is Sweet Pine Noel Mistletoe. Honestly, I just melted this one in my living room when I wasn't in there, only because it's out of season. I was just melting it because I think this is my last piece of Front Porch, and I have heard that it doesn't keep for very long. Like, after, you know, 6 months, 8 months, however long, it starts getting a weird smell, it won't have any throw. So I decided to just go ahead and use it to get it out of the way, even though it's out of season. So, I mean, it was a nice, sweet, like, vanilla pine scent. It just wasn't really what I was looking for when it's like 80 degrees outside, but I am glad that I got to melt it while it still had throw, because I didn't want to waste it. This next one was a sample from Moonbeam's Wax Melts. This is Scented Squirrel Garden, and this was just like a tiny little star shape, and I melted it in the morning when the scent that I had been melting was done. Like, I couldn't smell it anymore, and I just wanted something to melt for a little bit while I was getting ready. I only had like about an hour and a half, so I didn't want to put in something that I thought I would really, really love, because then I would have to turn it off to go to work, and then usually when I start up the wax again later, I don't get any throw from it again. So since this was a really small shape, I just popped it in. This was nice. It was definitely a very floral scent, and it was a little bit too heavy of a floral, I guess, for me for the spring. It was almost more of like a fall floral, if that makes sense. So it wasn't, again, something that was really great for the time of year, I think, but it was nice for the hour, hour and a half that I melted that before I went to work. This one is It's Always Tea Time from the Wonderland collection from Super Tarts. This one is Earl Grey Tea, Tea Cakes, Peppermint Swizzle Sticks, and Whipped Cream. This is another favorite. This was amazing. I didn't really think anything about this on cold. I mean, it was good, but I wasn't sure that I would love it. And then a couple people posted in her group about melting it at night the other day, and I thought, you know what, I should reach for that one. That actually sounds pretty good. I melted it the next morning, actually, and it was amazing. It was such a sweet tea and cakes, and you got just a little bit of a peppermint swizzle stick, like a true super sweet candy peppermint, and it was so creamy with that whipped cream. This was amazing. This was really, really good, and I can definitely see myself getting that again when that is empty. Let's see. This is Queen Petty from Jamie Ann's Wax, and this one is Juicy Peaches Sweet Vanilla Sparkling Champagne. I think this one was in my melt box last time when I had melted half in my bedroom. It's really perfumey, so that wasn't a favorite. I just melted it in my living room again when I wasn't in there too much. It does have a really strong throw. It's just super perfumey, which I didn't love. This one is Rainbow Krispies from Candy Panda. This is Rice Krispies Fruity Pebbles. I think I'd already melted half of this one, and I melted the other half in my living room. It didn't have great throw in my open, like, living room kitchen area. It was just kind of a really sweet scent. It wasn't too much of a cereal scent, but I also wasn't in there a ton. I'm just not in my living room a ton usually, so this was good. I remember it was really good when I melted half of it in my bedroom a while back. This is Sugar Sugar from Vintage Chic Scents. This was a sample. I'm not sure exactly what is in this, but I know that it is like one of their signature strawberry blends, I guess. When this came to me as a sample in December or January, the scent cup was super cracked. You can see it's just like super duper cracked. And I did not have a polypropylene bag to rebag it in, and I didn't necessarily feel the need to like buy some just for a sample that was cracked. So I still waited for it to cure, and then I finally thought, you know what, I should melt that and go ahead and see if it's going to have any throw, you know, since the scent could have totally escaped. It's super cracked. And so I cut it in half, put half in my bedroom, half in my living room. This was the best throw that I have gotten from a VCS scent, hands down. Her strawberry scents, it must be, do really great, because before this one, the best thrower to me was Strawberry Fields Forever, I think, which is like strawberries and cream zucchini bread. That was the best thrower before this one. This one blew that out of the water. It was so strong. This half of a scent shot, it was the sweetest, sugariest strawberry scent. It was so good. And this one I melted in the morning for like 3 or 4 hours, turned it off, went to work, came back home, turned it back on, and it still had amazing throw for like several more hours. I eventually just changed it because I was ready for something else. But this was so, so good. I definitely want more of this. As everyone says, a throw with VCS can be a little bit hit or miss. This one was definitely a hit. This was so good. It did great in the living room. That was so good. This one is, let's see, Autumn Hayride from The Scented Squirrel, Mown Hay, Sweet Balsam, Vetiver, and Cedarwood. This one was good. It's just kind of a, it's almost a laundry scent when it's actually melting. It smells like straight hay on cold, just like a really earthy, like, hay scent. But then when it's melting, it's almost more laundry. This one's good. Again, I just had a half scent shot left, so I was just using it to use it up. So not a ton to say about that one. This is White Rabbit from Sweet Wagon Scents, creamy vanilla ice cream with a dash of cinnamon and cherry on top. This was really good. This was another one that I was melting the second half in my living room, and it was really nice. You get the ice cream with this one more than the cherry and the hint of cinnamon, so this is a nice scent. If you don't like cherry, I don't think you'd like it, because you can definitely smell the cherry. This is Disneyland from Sassy Girl Aroma. This is creamsicle, cotton candy, lemonade, strawberry, pineapple, and whipped cream. My thoughts on this are not valid as far as the scent or SGA. I ordered this from the February 25th restock, and Julie, who is the owner of Sassy Girl, issued a recall on her Facebook group for this scent actually later in the day of the same day that I had melted it. I melted it that morning, like half of a big chunk, and I was a little bit disappointed because it didn't have very much throw at all, and I thought it would be really strong, and I thought, like, okay, maybe I just didn't cure it long enough. And then actually later that same day, she issued a recall for that scent and refunded everyone who had purchased it from that particular restock, because some piece of her equipment had stopped working right after she made this batch, and she found out that this batch actually didn't have any throw. So I'm not going to base, this was my first Sassy Girl that I ever melted, but I'm definitely not basing my opinion of Sassy Girl or this scent off of that, just because everybody makes mistakes, and she totally made it right. So I will probably be purchasing Disneyland again from some future replenish, maybe not the next one that's upcoming, just because I kind of have a lot of orders outstanding right now, but I probably will order it again in the future, because I definitely want a fresh batch that's going to perform well, because I've heard that this is a really, really good scent. So that's kind of the deal with that one. I do appreciate that she, like, immediately let everybody know and made it right, instead of, like, waiting for everybody to melt it and complain that it had no throw. So that really meant a lot to me and makes me think a lot of Julie as a vendor. This is Zucchini Butter Fudge Cupcake from Rainbow Melts. This is creamy zucchini, vanilla butter fudge, and sweet cupcakes. This was so, so, so good. I melted this at night. I got that vanilla fudge the most, just like a really sweet, creamy, rich, fudgy vanilla scent. Really, really good. That one was delicious. This is Super Tarts Zerboot Kisses. I think this is like raspberry and cinnamon rolls, something close to that. I liked this more on cold than I did on warm. It had just a little bit of a weird note on warm. I'm not sure. That raspberry mixed with the cinnamon just didn't sit super well with me on warm. I loved it on cold. I'm not sure if I will order this in a clam and try it out some more. I probably will at some point, but it wasn't a favorite, but it was good. This one is Annabeth. This is Saltwater Taffy and Pink Sugar from Super Tarts. I tried this one to see if I needed to order it in a BAM bag from the most recent pre-order. It was good. It just didn't have as strong of throw as I was really wanting. I melted one cube in my warmer, which is what I always melt for Super Tarts. That's pretty standard for what I melt in my bedroom. And I could smell it. It just wasn't too strong to me, so I don't know. I mean, it hadn't cured for a super long time, so I'll definitely melt through this clam and try it some more, but I didn't end up ordering it in a BAM bag. This next one is Grovu from Super Tarts. This is Cola Float and Cotton Candy Cookies. I actually melted this one to see if I needed Coven in a BAM bag since it had the cola in it. I loved this. I liked it so much more than I thought. On cold, I didn't really like this, but on warm, that cola was such a nice scent, and then you got the cotton candy. This was really, really good. I didn't end up getting Coven just because I narrowed my list down to only the top three that I wanted, and that just didn't end up being in my top three, but this was so much better than I expected, and I would definitely continue to reorder that one. So, so good. This next one is Best Friends Forever from Rose Girls, Pineapple Lemonade and Frosted Cupcakes. This was really good. I got just like a really sweet pineapple, I would say the most. And then you could smell like a frosting cakey note from that frosted cupcake. I didn't get as much lemonade on warm. It was mostly like pineapple and a kind of buttercream bakery scent. But this was really, really good. I enjoyed that one. This is Finn and Jake from Super Tart Zesty Grapefruit and Pink Sugar Crystals. The first time I melted this, I was not a huge fan. It was just, it was kind of weird to me somehow, that grapefruit and the pink sugar. But the next time that I melted it, those two blended together so nicely, and it was a really nice scent. I don't know how to describe it. It was really good. It was so much better than it was the first time I melted it. It was sweeter, I think. I think the pink sugar came out more, so that one was really good. This is Alexander Hamilton from Razzle Dazzle Wax, and this is, I don't have the scent notes on it, but it was basically like a cinnamon red hot scent. Again, melted half in my living room just to use up the rest of it. It was a strong red hot scent. This is Hush by Mountain from Blank Label, Lavender Chamomile Bedtime Bath. This was a beautiful nighttime blend. It wasn't too strong, but it was perfect for just like a bedroom nighttime blend. I really enjoyed that one. This is Red Pop from Moonbeam's Wax Melts. This was just like a fizzy strawberry soda scent. Not as strong as I would have hoped, I don't think, and didn't last for a super long time, but it was good. I don't think I would reorder this, but I melted the other half in my living room, and it just didn't last a super long time. It was fine. This is Femme Fatale from Candy Panda. This was some sort of cereal scent. I don't have the scent notes on it, and I don't remember exactly what this was, but it was good. I think it might have had, like, pistachio pudding cake in it or something. That one was good. I'm sorry. I don't remember the scent notes for that. This is Never Been Kissed from Super Tart's Blackberry Jam Cookies Raspberry Zinger Waffle Cone. This was really, really good. You got the blackberry jam cookies with just a hint of like a zingy raspberry scent. That one was a really nice fruity bakery. This is Hello Gorgeous from Vintage Chic Scents. This is Strawberry Mint Marshmallow. Again, great thrower, great scent. Really good strawberry mixed with just enough mint. This was really nice. I think her strawberry blends are really like a solid option for me when it comes to VCS. I've had really good luck with her strawberry blends. This is Mother Ginger and the Polichinelles from Sweet Wagon Scents. This is freshly baked gingerbread. I think that says toasted with, I'm sorry, I can't read that, with vanilla buttercream. This one was good. This was another one that I was just using the other half to get rid of. I think I'm done with all of my out of season scents that I just needed to finish up melting after this box. So I'm happy about that. That was a really good gingerbread scent, but again, just kind of out of season for me. This is Pop My Cherry from Candy Panda. This was black cherry, toasted marshmallow, tea, and cakes. This was really good for a while, and then that dark cherry scent got a little bit weird for me and wasn't my absolute favorite. I don't know. Cherries kind of hit or miss for me. Sometimes it ends up smelling a little bit medicinal, and sometimes it's good. It's really, if I think about it being medicinal, then my mind kind of thinks that it is. So I don't know. That one was good, but not one probably that I would buy again. This is Nova Prime from Super Tarts. This is Bakery Shop Sweet Lemon Meringue and Blackberry Cream. This one is really good. This one's always a hit with me. You get a really like sweet lemon bakery with that sweet blackberry that Brandy has that's so good. This is a really good scent. I enjoy that one when I'm looking for a fruity bakery. This is Cucumber Melon from Jamie Ann's Wax. This was a sample that I got, so I melted this as soon as I filmed that haul, and this was really, really good. It was, I think this is a Bath & Body Works scent. It smelled exactly like sort of a throwback Bath & Body Works scent that I used to use all the time. It was really sweet. It was spa-like. I mean, not necessarily, it didn't have like that fresh note, but you know how cucumber just like smells fresh, so it smelled like a really nice spa scent. It was really strong. It lasted for a long time. This was one that I changed just because I was ready for something else, but that one was really nice, so I would definitely order that from her again. This is Taste the Rainbow from Rose Girls. This is Satsuma, Key Lime, Purple Cow, and Chicks Dig It. And this is just a really kind of bright, zesty, fruity blend. I wouldn't say If I could get one thing the most, I think I can smell the satsuma and the lime, but everything else is just kind of a mix. You know, it's just like a really fruity, zesty blend. This one was really nice. I'm trying to make sure I don't miss anything here. This is Sunshine and Sparkles from Sweet Wagon Scents from one of her macaron samplers. I melted the whole piece, and it is Blue Hawaiian Cocktail and an Orange Creamsicle and Fizzy Soda. This one was really, really good. The Blue Hawaiian was so nice, just like a fruity tropical drink. This was really strong and fizzy. I'm really excited to melt through some more of that sampler because that one was really nice. This is Saturday Evening Post from Vintage Chic Scents. This is just Zucchini Noel, and it sounds like a really basic scent, like, you know, oh, that wouldn't be anything special. This, again, was actually really, really good. This had a really good throw. I won't say, like, strong. It was like a high medium, but stronger than I've gotten from a lot of my VCS. I don't know. It's just so good. It's just so sweet. She has like a really nice creamy zucchini and then blended with that Vanilla Bean Noel. This was just really, really nice. This was a perfect just sort of straight bakery scent to melt at night. And I really enjoyed that one. If you like bakery, I would definitely recommend that one. So we have one more little one down here. This is a free sample from Sweet Wagon Scents and Linda's Carnival Daydream. I'm not sure what the scent notes are for this one, and I actually don't remember this a ton. I remember it was a star shape. Oh, you know what? I think this was a sweet, almost like a funnel cake, powdered sugar type scent. It wasn't super strong, but it was just kind of a nice light bakery, I think, if I'm remembering this one correctly. Let me see if I'm missing anything else. I don't think so. So my last thing here is this bakery bag from Sweet Wagon Scents and Arena. This is fresh coconut buttery sugar cookies topped with powdered sugar and marshmallow fluff. This was really, really good. I'm so glad I got this. It was a really nice sweet bakery coconut. It wasn't too strong, but it was just what you would expect this scent to smell like. I mean, it was just beautiful. It did last for a long time. It was perfect to melt at night. Just such a creamy, sweet bakery coconut scent is what I mostly got from that one. So I'm just trying to make sure I didn't miss any little bitty packages down on the bottom. I don't think I did though. So thank you so much for watching. I've really been enjoying doing these warm reviews because it helps me to sort of reminisce on what I've melted as well, and sort of remember which ones I loved and which ones I wasn't so fond of, so that I know what I should reorder and sort of what orders I should place during the month. So this is a lot of fun, and I hope that y'all enjoy them as well. Like I've mentioned in the previous ones, if there's anything that would make these more enjoyable for you, if I did it by vendor or by scent type, like, I don't really know how many different ways there are that I could do it, but currently I just kind of throw these all in a box and go through them, and I enjoy that just because obviously that's the easiest thing to do. But if y'all have a strong preference that you'd like to see it another way, I could definitely try to do that. So as always, thank you so much for watching. Please feel free I can't talk now. Feel free to leave any questions, comments, suggestions down below. I would love to talk to you in the comments, and I will see you very soon in another video. Have a great day, guys. Bye.